Good afternoon, everyone. We will talk now today in this lecture the reaction stoichiometry, limiting and excess reactant, fractional conversion, and extent of reaction. Okay, so this is the four concepts we will deal or we will take it through this lecture. We will not conduct any mole balance or mass balance for this lecture. We will just only be introduced to this concept, the reaction stoichiometry, limiting and excess reactant, fractional conversion, and extent of reaction. So let's start. For the reaction stoichiometry, in general, if we have a chemical reaction, for example, that like the one we have here for SO2, react with oxygen to give us sodium sulfur trioxide. So we will see numbers beside each component, each compound. So for the SO2, we see number 2. For O2, we see number 1. It's not written, but it is 1. And SO3, we see number 2. Okay. This is the stoichiometric coefficient. For the SO2, the stoichiometric coefficient is 2. For O2, the stoichiometric coefficient is 1. And for SO3, the stoichiometric coefficient is 2. What this reaction tells us that 2 moles, this number is means that 2 moles of SO2 should react with 1 mole of O2 to give us 2 moles of SO3. This is what the chemical reaction tells us and what these numbers tell us. If we get this 2, the stoichiometric coefficient for SO2, and divided it by 1, the stoichiometric coefficient is of O2, we say this, it is a stoichiometric ratio. A stoichiometric ratio. Okay? Okay. So, if we have 200 moles of SO2, reacting with 100 moles of O2. Okay, so we have feed. We have a reactor, and we introduce a feed to this reactor, SO2 and O2. There is a two reactant, SO2 and O2. They are introduced so that the amount of SO2 is 200 moles. So for like this example, we have 200 moles of SO2 and 100 moles of oxygen, two reactors together to give us SO3. Sulfur trioxide. According to that, the feed ratio is 200 of SO2 over O2 is 200 over 100. So the feed ratio in this case is 200 over 100, which means that it is 2:1 or 2 over 1. Okay? So the feed ratio here is 2 over 1. So what about the stoichiometric ratio? Is it the same? According to the number here, 2:1, it is the same. So if the feed ratio equals the stoichiometric ratio, this means that both of the reactant will be consumed. At the end of the reaction, there will be no sodium oxide dioxide left. I'm sorry, sulfur dioxide left or oxygen left. Both the reactant will disappear. Okay, and of course we'll form the our product sulfur trioxide. Okay, so what will be the case if we introduce O2 with the same or with 100 moles, still the same 100 moles of O2, but lesser amount of SO2? So this means that for the we have 100 moles of O2. And 200 less than 200 mole of SO2, for example, 100 mole of SO2. What will happen here? That SO2 is introduced to a lesser amount than the required by the stoichiometric reaction. Okay, so this means that SO2 will be used up. So all the O2. The O2 will react with all SO2 and some of the O2 will be remaining. This means that O2 will be the excess, will be present in excess or introduced in an excess amount more than the required or more than it is told, we are told according to the stoichiometric of the reaction. And SO2 are introduced to a smaller amount. So SO2 is a limiting reactant. So what will happen if O2 was introduced in a smaller amount and O2 was introduced to a larger amount? So according to the stoichiometric feed ratio, stoichiometric ratio and the feed ratio, it is 2:1. So what will happen if we introduce more than 200 mole of SO2 and less than 100 mole of O2? Now, all the O2 will be consumed and SO2 will not be consumed. Only 200 mole of SO2 will be consumed and the remaining will be present in excess. This will mean that O2 will be the limiting reactant and SO2 will be the excess reactant. So, what is the definition of the limiting reactant? It is a reactant that would be eliminated first if a reaction proceeds to completion. So if the reaction completed to the final finished, okay? So this will be the reactant that will be completely consumed. No reactant will be present for this reactant. So what is the excess? It is the other reactant or termed excess reactant. So the one that will be remaining at the end of or at the completion of the reaction. So how to determine if this reactant, if we have A and B reactant together to form C, how to know if A is the excess reactant and B is the limiting reactant? How to know which one is the limiting, which one is the will be present in excess? To know this, we have to compare the amount or the ratio, the feed ratio of both reactants and the stoichiometric ratio from the chemical reaction equation for these two reactants. So let's see an example, number 8. The hydrogenation of acetylene to form ethane. So hydrogen, or according to the stoichiometric equation here, the 2 mole of hydrogen will react with 1 mole of acetylene to form 1 mole of ethane. Okay? So the stoichiometric ratio for hydrogen to acetylene is 2:1. Suppose that, he's telling that we have 200 kilomole of acetylene are fed to the reactor. So for this acetylene, we have 200 kilomole per hour fed to the reactor. For the hydrogen, we have 50 kilomole per hour of hydrogen fed to the reactor. What we want is to determine the limiting and excess reactant. From the chemical reaction equation, we determine the stoichiometric ratio of hydrogen to acetylene, which will be 2:1. The second step is to determine the feed ratio, the amount where hydrogen will be introduced to the reactor and the acetylene, what is the amount of moles of acetylene that will be fed to the reactor. So the feed ratio here of hydrogen to acetylene is the amount of hydrogen feed, which is 50 kilomole per hour, divided by the amount of acetylene feed, 20 kilomole per hour. What we forget here is 2.5:1, which means comparing that to the stoichiometric ratio, we'll find that it is greater than the stoichiometric ratio. So the feed ratio is greater than the stoichiometric ratio. This means that one of these reactants are introduced in excess. Which one will make this this feed ratio greater? It is hydrogen. If the amount of hydrogen was introduced instead of 50 was lesser, we will get a lesser amount of 2.5. Yes? So this means that the hydrogen is introduced to in an excess amount. So as long as the feed ratio is greater than the stoichiometric ratio, this means that hydrogen was fed in excess, is fed in greater than the stoichiometric proportion. So hydrogen is the excess reactant and acetylene is the limiting reactant. Okay? So, how excess? What is the amount of excess? We can say the fractional excess of this reactant. Okay, it is excess. We know that hydrogen for the past case, or the last example, we know that the hydrogen is the excess reactant and the acetylene was the limiting reactant. But what is the amount of excess? How the fractional excess, okay, of hydrogen? We can calculate it based on knowing two variables. The first one is the feed. If we know the number of mole of an excess reactant present in the feed, the number, if we have a reactant A introduced to the reactor, what is the amount of this reactant A that was fed to the reactor, which is the amount fed, and it is represented by number of mole fed. So the number of mole of reactant A fed subtracted from the number of mole, which is the definition here, is the number of moles or the amount of A needed to react completely with the limiting reactant, to finish the limiting reactant. Okay, so for the NA stoichiometry here, this means the amount of A needed to react completely with the limiting reactant. If we have a limiting reactant B, so we want to finish all the amount of P that was fed. Okay, so then we will define again, we'll divide it again with the number of moles of A stoichiometry. So the fractional excess of A, to calculate it, we will follow this equation. Let's have an example to understand it more. So again, for the same example here that we get in example 8, we have acetylene reacting with hydrogen to get ethane. We have 20 kilomole of hydrogen of acetylene feed, 50 kilomole of hydrogen feed. What we want here is to determine the fractional excess. To remind us of the equation of the fractional excess, which means the number of mole of excess reactant feed minus the number of moles of excess reactant that will completely finish the limiting product, the limiting reactant, divided by the amount of compound or the limiting reactant that will completely the number of moles of excess reactant that will completely finish the limiting reactant. In example 8, we calculated that, or we know that the hydrogen is fed in excess. So the hydrogen is the excess reactant. So we will calculate the fractional excess of hydrogen. To do this, we need to know the amount of hydrogen fed. So what is the amount of hydrogen feed? It is given here, 50 kilomole of hydrogen. We will go and write it. The number of moles of hydrogen feed is 50 kilomole per hour. It's given. The one thing that we want to, the remaining unknown here is the number of hydrogen or the number of mole of hydrogen that should react with the limiting reactant, which in this case is the acetylene, and completely finish it. So to react with all the acetylene, we want to know the amount of acetylene feed. We write the equation here. We write that it is the acetylene here, the stoichiometric is 1 for the acetylene. And for the hydrogen, the stoichiometric coefficient is 2. So 1 mole of acetylene will react with 2 mole of hydrogen to get 1 mole of ethane. The amount of it of acetylene here is 20 kilomole per hour. So according to this reaction, because the reaction proceed according to the stoichiometry. So if we have 1 mole of acetylene, it will react with 2 moles of hydrogen. So what if we have 20 mole of acetylene? What will be the amount of hydrogen that will react with it? Okay, so if we have 1 mole of acetylene, it will react with 2 moles of hydrogen. What if we have 20 moles of acetylene? What will be the amount of hydrogen that will react with it? So it is 20 times 2 divided by 1. If you know the scissor calculation, okay? So it is 20 by 2 divided by 1. So this will let us know the amount of hydrogen that will completely react with acetylene and finish it, okay? So the stoichiometric amount of hydrogen here in this case will be 2 times 20. So it is 2 times 20 divided by 1, giving us 40 kilomole per hour. This is the amount of hydrogen that will react with all the acetylene and finish it. And it is logic. If we have 1 mole of acetylene reacting with 2 mole of hydrogen, okay, according to the chemical reaction, it is the same. If we have 20 moles of acetylene, it will react with 40 moles of hydrogen. Back to calculating the fractional excess, if we remember that it is required to determine the fractional excess here, we have the number of the amount of feed of hydrogen, we have the stoichiometric amount of hydrogen that will react with all the acetylene. Okay, so now we can calculate the fractional excess of hydrogen. Fractional excess of hydrogen will be the amount feed here is 50 given minus the stoichiometry amount of hydrogen, which is 40 that will react, divided by the stoichiometric amount of hydrogen again. So it is the fractional excess 0.25. This means there is 25% of hydrogen is present in excess in the feed. 25% of the hydrogen introduced to the reactor was in excess, will not react. It will remain to the end of the reaction. Okay, hope that this is clear. So we get now, was introduced to the stoichiometric reaction. We know how to calculate the limiting and excess reactants and to calculate the fractional excess. Another term here is the fractional conversion. So the fractional, we know that the reaction, the chemical reaction, in most cases do not complete to the end. It is maybe in equilibrium, it doesn't finish, not all the reactants will be finished, okay? So if we have a chemical reactor and we introduce a feed to this reactor, we will end up with the product and some of the feed, some of the reactant that was not reacted. This will be separated, so the product will be separated from the unreacted reactant, and the unreacted reactant will be recycled back to again to the reactor. Okay, so this is one of the important function of the recycling. So as you can see, there is some of the reactants that does not react. So we want to know that how the amount of fractional conversion. Okay, what is the percent on conversion of the reactant? For example, we have a reactant A introduced to the reactor. We have coming out. So it is feed A. And coming out A as a product. How? What is the percent of A that was converted? Okay, this is what mean by fractional conversion, or what is the fractional of A that did react or to form products. So again, so the fractional conversion here is the mole of A, for example, if we have A, the mole of A reacted, the amount of A that reacted, divided by the amount of A that was fed. This will give up a term is called fractional conversion. Okay, and the fractional conversion, if the reaction proceed to completion, so if all the reactant feed all reacted, again it will be one. So okay. So the mole reacted. If all the reactant was did react, okay, it will be the same as the number of feet. All the feet reacted. So it will be at the end fractional conversion will be one. If the conversion is 100%, so the fractional conversion will be one. The fraction of unreacted portion of the reactant is 1 minus F, okay? So the fractional conversion, again, according to this equation, is calculating by dividing the moles of reactant by the mole divided by the mole of feed, okay? So let's apply an example to understand it. So for example 10 here, if we have 100 mole of reactant, whatever is the name of this reactant, so we have feed 100 mole of reactant to reactor, and we have 90 moles reacted. 90 moles of this reactant did react. Can we calculate the fractional conversion? According to the equation, the fractional conversion for this reactant is moles reacted divided by moles feed. For this case, the moles reacted is 90 moles. So it is 90 moles reacted. We will substitute by 90. Okay. Moles feed in this case, it is 100. It is written as a mistake. So it is 100, not 10. We will get a fractional conversion of 0.9. This means that the percent conversion is 90%, and the fraction of unreacted product, unreacted reactant is 0.1. So again, the fractional conversion here is 0.9. This means that 90% of the reactant did react. Only 10% of the reactant will be remaining. Okay. Again, let's apply the concept of the fractional conversion, or use the equation of fractional conversion. If we have 20 moles per minute of reactant is feed. So we have a reactant that will be fed to a reactor. The rate of feed is 20 moles per minute. Now, if they are giving us the percent conversion. So in this case, the percent conversion of this reactant is 80%. What we want is to find the amount of feed reacted. From this equation, the fractional conversion is equal mole reacted divided by mole feed. If you want to know the moles or mole feed, so it will be, okay, so the mole feed, find the amount of feed reacted, I'm sorry. We have the mole feed, we have the fractional conversion, we want to calculate the moles reacted. So if we to know the mole reacted, we multiply the mole feed by the fractional conversion. Multiply the mole feed by the fractional conversion. So amount of reactant that did react equal the moles of reactant feed times the fractional conversion. In this case, it is given that the moles feed of this reactant is 20 mole per minute. And it is also given in this example that the fractional conversion, this is percent conversion, for the fraction it is divided by 100, it is 0.8. At the end, we get the amount of the reactant that did react equals 16 mole per minute has reacted. Okay. We will apply this one more example. For example number 12, back again to the hydrogenation of acetylene to form ethane. We was given that 20 mole, already given in example 9 and 8, that there is 20 mole of acetylene that was fed, and 50 mole of hydrogen also was fed to the reactor. But there is also 50 kilomole of per hour of ethane also fit to the reactor. So we have acetylene and hydrogen in the feed, and also ethane was also feed. Suppose that after some time, after passing like, for example, 1 hour, for example, 30 kilomole of hydrogen has reacted. We have, for the feed, we have 50 kilomole of hydrogen. 30 kilomole of them did react. How much of each species, for in this case, or each component, will be present in the reactor at that moment? Okay, once 30 kilomole of hydrogen did react, what is the remaining amount of the reactant and what is the amount of product that will be present after, for example, time T, after 1 hour, for example? Okay, so what is required here? The amount of remaining reactant and the amount of remaining product or the produced product. So let's take one by one. So for example, the easiest one here to start with is the amount of hydrogen. So what we need to, what we want here, the amount of remaining hydrogen. It is telling us in this example how much of each species will be present in the reactor at that moment. So the amount of remaining hydrogen after passing time T. So the amount of remaining hydrogen is, can be calculated if we know the amount of it minus the amount reacted. So if we know the amount of hydrogen feed and we take away the amount of hydrogen reacted, it will be the amount of hydrogen remaining. Okay, both are given for this case. The amount of hydrogen feed, it is given here in the example, it is 50 kilomole of hydrogen. The amount of hydrogen reacted in this case also is given. Suppose that after some time, 30 kilomole of hydrogen has reacted. So amount of hydrogen reacted in this case is 30. So now 50, take away, we take it, take away 30, and the remaining amount of hydrogen will be 20 kilomole per hour, okay. So the amount of remaining hydrogen in this case is 20 kilomole. Okay, so now we finished with the calculations regarding the hydrogen. So what about the acetylene? How to calculate the amount of acetylene? Again, this purple amount of acetylene remaining equals the amount of acetylene feed minus the amount of acetylene reacted. Do we have the amount of acetylene feed? Yes, it is given. The amount of acetylene feed is 20 kilomole of acetylene. So we already know that the amount of acetylene present in this case is 20 kilomole. Not present, feed to the reactor. So what about the amount of acetylene that did react? How the acetylene will react? The acetylene will react with the hydrogen. If we have 30 kilomole of hydrogen that reacted, it is of course reacted with acetylene. So how to know this? From the stoichiometry. If we write, write here acetylene, hydrogen, and ethane. According to the stoichiometry, it is 1 mole of acetylene will react with 2 mole with hydrogen to form 1 mole of ethane. The amount of heat for each component is 20 moles of acetylene, 50 moles of hydrogen, 50 moles of acetylene, of ethane. Amount reacted, we don't know here. We want to know the amount of acetylene that did react. The amount of hydrogen reacted is already given, is 30 moles. The amount of ethane produced is not known. We want to calculate it. So if you remember the scissor calculation that I said, it is if we have 1 mole of acetylene reacting with 2 mole of hydrogen, and we have 30 moles of hydrogen that react, what is the amount of acetylene that will react? 1 times 30 over 20. Okay, so from a stoichiometric reaction, from the stoichiometric reaction, if we have 1 mole of acetylene reacting with 2 mole of hydrogen, okay? So what if we have 30 mole of hydrogen? What will that reacted? What will be the amount of acetylene that will react with it? Okay? The same here, if 1 mole of acetylene reacting with 2 mole of hydrogen, What if we have 30 moles of hydrogen reacted? What will be the amount of acetylene that will react with it? So 1 times 30 over 2. So the amount of acetylene reacted is 1 times 30 over 2, which is 15 kilomole per hour. Calculating the amount of acetylene remaining, it's amount of feed minus the amount of acetylene reacted. So for the feed, it is 20 kilomole, it's given. For the amount of acetylene reacted, we already calculated it, it is 15. So the total amount of acetylene remaining is 5 kilomole per hour. We will do the same for the ethan. But in this case, please note that ethan is a product, so we will not take away, it will add up to the product. So if ethan was present in the feed, it will not be consumed. It will we will produce more ethan and more ethan through the reaction of hydrogen with acetylene. So it will be the total amount of ethan remaining is the amount of feed plus the amount of ethan produced. Okay. So the amount of ethan feed, it is given, it is 50 kilomole. Okay. So it is given that the amount of ethan feed is 50 kilomole. So what is what about the amount of ethan produced? How to calculate it from the stoichiometry? We have mole of, 1 mole of acetylene reacting with 2 mole of hydrogen to produce 1 mole of acetylene. So if we have 30 mole of hydrogen reacting, what will be the amount of ethan that will be produced? So it will be 1 times 30 over 20 or over 2. So it again, it will be 1 times 30 over 2. So So from the stoichiometric reaction, amount of ethan produced will be 1 times 30 over 2. It will be 15 kilomole per hour, which means that the total amount of ethan that will remain at the end of the reaction or at the end of time to T, it will be 50 plus 15, which is 65 kilomole per hour. The last definition or the last concept I want to introduce to you is the extent of reaction. So it is written in this Greek letter, okay, and pronounced as xi, okay, xi. So this extent of reaction is a measure how far a reaction has proceeded from time zero to time to the end point. So how many moles did react for every reactant and how many moles is produced for every product? Okay, let's see now, we have A reacting with B to produce C according to this equation. 1 mole of A will react with two mole of B to produce 1 mole of C. Okay, so A is a reactant. I make a table or just a sketch. It will be easier to see this in this way or to write it in this way. So for the reactant, A is a reactant, B is a reactant, and product C. According to the stoichiometry, 1 mole of A, so it is 1, the coefficient, stoichiometric coefficient of A is 1, stoichiometric coefficient of B is 2, and the stoichiometric coefficient of C is 1. It is telling us that the number of, or we start with number of mole of A, 0. So it is the number NA0, it is the number of mole of A at time 0, or at the start of the reaction. In this case, it is the number of moles of B at the start of the reaction. And in this case, it is the number of moles of C at the start of the reaction. I am marking it at start. So what will happen at the end? Once time T passes or at the end of the reaction, what will happen? Some of the introduced number of moles of the reactant will react. And it is written as, so it is done at the end. This is the remaining amount, okay? And this is the amount that did react, okay? The amount did react. So So it is for the remaining amount, it is the number of mole of A that was introduced at the start. And then because it is reacted, so it will decrease. So we will put a minus sign here. Then the amount stoichiometry is 1 times Xi, or the extent of the reaction. Okay. 1 minus Xi is the amount of moles that reacted from A. Now NA0 minus 1 Xi is the amount of moles that is remaining of A at the end of the reaction. Okay. For B, for the reactant B, we have the stoichiometric amount 2 at the start, the number of moles of B at the start of the reaction at time 0 is NB0. At the end, number of moles present at the start, take away 2 stoichiometric times Xe. Minus 2 Xe is the amount of Bs that did react. All this is the amount of B remaining. Okay. For the product, C, the stoichiometry is 1. At the start, the number of mole of C present. But is at the end, in this case, it is a product, so the sign will be plus. Okay, because the product will be increased. So what is the amount of increase? Is 1 Xc, which is 1 is the stoichiometry. C is the extent of the reaction. It is the same value for Z, but the difference is the sign and the coefficient. Okay, so number of moles of A at the end is this value. Number of moles of B at the end will be this value. And number of moles of C at the end will be this value. To understand this, we will get an example regarding a reaction, chemical reaction of ammonia. For the production of ammonia, so nitrogen is reacted, so 1 mole of nitrogen will react with 3 moles of hydrogen to form 2 moles of ammonia. We were told that the feed to the continuous reactor consists of 100 moles per second of nitrogen, so the amount of nitrogen feed to the reactor is 100 moles. Feed also contains 300 moles of hydrogen. Okay, and 1 mole of argon. Argon is an inert gas, so 1 mole of argon will be fed and will be produced as 1 mole of argon. No change will occur to the argon. Okay, so the nitrogen will react with hydrogen to form ammonia. If you know that the fractional conversion of hydrogen is 0.6. So we was given the fractional conversion, if you remember the law of equation of fractional conversion. Okay. Calculate the outlet flow rate. So of hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia. We want to know the amount of hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia produced, or the amount of hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia that is remaining at the end of the reaction. In other words. Also, we want to determine the extent of reaction, which is the letter Xc. Okay. So first, we was given the fractional conversion of hydrogen, which can be written as the fractional conversion of hydrogen is the moles of hydrogen that reacted divided by the mole of hydrogen feed. We know the moles of hydrogen that is feed. Okay. We know the fractional conversion of hydrogen, so we can know directly the mole of hydrogen reacted. Why do we want the mole of hydrogen reacted? Because if you remember, we take this before, is the mole of hydrogen remaining. To calculate the amount of hydrogen remaining, which is one of the requirements for, we want to determine, or one of the required calculations. Here is the flow rate of hydrogen. The outlet flow rate of hydrogen, which means the amount of moles of hydrogen that will be produced from the reactor, or which is remaining. So the amount of hydrogen that will be produced is the amount of hydrogen that will be remaining after the reaction go, which is equal to the amount of hydrogen feed minus the amount of hydrogen reacted. The amount of hydrogen feed is a given. The amount of hydrogen feed is a given is 30 mole of hydrogen. Okay, is feed. The feed contains 30 mole of hydrogen. So the amount of hydrogen feed is 300. The amount of hydrogen reacted, we will calculate it from the fractional conversion. Okay, so the amount of hydrogen reacted equals the moles of hydrogen feed times the fractional conversion. Mole of hydrogen reacted equal fractional feed of hydrogen times the moles feed. So the fractional conversion is given here, 0.6. And the amount of mole of hydrogen that was feed is given is 300. So the total moles of hydrogen that did react is 100 mole per second. We write the value here, so 300 take away 180 will be 120 moles of per second of hydrogen remaining. And this is required, or we want to calculate it for this, to solve this example. Okay, so this is the first requirement. The next step is to calculate the number of the amount of nitrogen remaining, the amount of ammonia remaining, and the extent of the reaction. Let's see in the next slide. So as we know that the amount of hydrogen remaining at the end is 120 mole per second. Again, the moles of hydrogen remaining at the end is 120 mole per second. If you remember that at the end, if we put nitrogen, hydrogen, and ammonia, and we did at the start, at the end, so the amount of hydrogen in this case would be 300, remaining 300 minus 3 Xe. So let's go through this table to know for this reaction, for the ammonia production reaction. So for this reaction, we have nitrogen. 1 mole of nitrogen will react with 3 moles of hydrogen to give us 2 moles of ammonia. Okay. So we will put reactant, reactant, product, and inert. We have 4 components. 2 reactants, 1 product, which is ammonia, and 1 inert, which is the argon. According to the stoichiometry coefficient, 1 mole of nitrogen, okay, will react with 3 moles of hydrogen, in this case will be 3, to produce 2 moles of ammonia. For the stoichiometric coefficient of ammonia is 2. According to the chemical reaction equation, argon is 0 because it is not involved in this, is this chemical reaction. It is an inert. At the start, which is meant mean the feed, the amount of feed, reactant, and if there is product and inert to the reactor. What is the amount of feed nitrogen to the reactor? It is given. It is 100 mole, okay, per second. So what about the amount of hydrogen feed? It is 300 given. Product, it was not told before that there is no product. No ammonia was feed. So the feed to the reactor is 100 mole per second of nitrogen, 300 mole per second of hydrogen, and 1 mole per second of argon. They didn't tell us that they introduced any ammonia in the feed. So as a result, the amount at the start is the amount of nitrogen, of ammonia present in this reaction, or feed to the reactor is 0. The amount of argon feed is 1. It is given also. So at the end of the reaction, as the reaction started, so it is at time 0. So this is the moles, the number of moles of every reactant and the product in this reaction. As the time passes and the reaction completed, or time T passes, at the end of the reaction, this will be the number of moles remaining. What is the number of moles remaining? The number of moles feed minus the number of moles reacted. So to calculate the number of moles reacted, it is a reactant, so it will take minus, sign minus, okay? And then we put the stoichiometry and then the extent of the reaction, see. This will be the moles of nitrogen remaining at the end of the reaction. And this will be the moles reacted or produced 1 minus xc, and the sign minus is not, it means that it is consumed. Minus, it means consumption. For the hydrogen, the more the remaining is, the more the present as the stored, minus the amount reacted. What is the amount reacted? Because it is a reactant, it will be take sign minus. And then we put the stoichiometric ratio for the hydrogen in the equation here, and multiply it with the extent of the reaction xc. All this represents the mole of hydrogen remaining at the end of the reaction, or the moles of hydrogen that will be produced from the reactor. This part corresponding to the mole reacted, the amount of hydrogen that reacted. So of course, because it is a reaction and the hydrogen is introduced as a reactant, it will be consumed and the amount at the end will be less. For the product here, for the ammonia, we have at the start there was no moles or no product present. At the end, there will be amount, this will be the amount of ammonia present. So the plus here means that it is a product and it is addition. So the amount of ammonia will increase at the end because it is a product. So the quantity of increase here, is 2. Okay, the stoichiometric 2 times the extent of the reaction xc. Let me, because there was a mistake here, it is minus 3, because, and for this, for things to be clear, and don't occur any confusion, okay? Okay, so for here, the amount of ammonia produced is this term plus 2 xc, extent of reaction. Okay, of course there is no reactant or produced, and the number at the end, number of moles of argon at the end would be 1. Okay, so let's interpret this to allow us to solve the amount of remaining. Remember, what we want here is the amount of nitrogen remaining at the end or produced from the reactor. If you remember here, calculate the outlet flow rate, hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia, and determine the extent of the reaction. We already calculated the amount of hydrogen here. What we want, the amount of nitrogen present at the end of the reaction, the amount of ammonia present at the end of the reaction, the amount of argon present at the end of the reaction. Of course, the amount of argon, moles of argon remaining at the end is 1 mole per second. This is the easiest one. Okay. So to calculate the number, the moles of nitrogen remaining at the end, according to this table, it is 100 minus 1 times extent of the reaction, or xc. 100 minus 1 xc. So how to know, if we know the value of the extent of the reaction of the xc, we will directly know the amount of nitrogen that will be remaining at the end. So which one we already know? Which amount we already know? We just calculated before in the past step, the moles of hydrogen remaining, 120 moles. So for this case, we know that the amount of hydrogen remaining is 300 minus 3 xc, which is equal to 120 moles per second. So we can directly know the extent of the reaction, the value of the extent of the reaction is 100 minus 300. Divided by minus 3, so it will be 90. This has no value. The extent of the reaction, or say xc, doesn't have any values, okay? Because this is a value of a mole per second and this mole per second. So as we know the extent of the reaction, we directly substitute with 90 instead of the xc here. So 100 minus 90, it will be 10 moles per second of nitrogen remaining. So we already calculated the amount of nitrogen remaining, the amount of hydrogen remaining. We know the amount of argon remaining or produced out of the reactor. So the last thing to calculate is the amount of ammonia produced. According to this table, it is 0 plus 2 xc. So most of ammonia remaining at the end or so produced at the end is plus 2 times the extent of the reaction. So it is 2 times 90, which is 180 mole per second. And it is required. So now we solve this problem. We get we determine the extent of the reaction. We calculated the amount of hydrogen, nitrogen, and ammonia produced from this reactor.